Hey guys, the question is, Indigo Incorporation had outstanding $6,180,000 of 12% bonds, interest payable July 31st and January 31st, due in 10 years. On July 1st, it issued $9,610,000 of 10% 15-year bonds, interest payable July 1st and January 1st at 97. A portion of the proceeds was used to call the 12% bonds with an amortized discount of $185,400 at 103 on August 1st. Prepare the journal entries necessary to record issue of the new bonds and the refunding of the bonds. So first of all, we will prepare journal entry to record the issuance of bonds. So the entry will be cash account debit to bonds payable. Here we can see that $6,180,000 of bonds due in 10 years on July 1st it issued $9,610,000 15 years bond at 97. First of all, 9000 bonds payable is of 9,610,000 of dollar. Here it is issued at 97. So here 9,610,000 multiplied by 97%. So there is a discount on bonds payable of 3%. Discount on bonds payable of 3%. Or we can say bonds payable amount less cash amount. $288,300 on July 1st. Now the second journal entry to record the refunding of bonds. So first of all, to record issue of bonds. Now to record refunding of bonds. So here, a portion of the proceed was used to call the 12% bonds with an amortized discount at 103 on August 1st. So here on August 1st, the entry will be bonds payable account debit to cash account debit to discount on bonds payable account credit. Here the value is 185,000. A portion of the proceed was used to call the 12% bonds with at 103, and yeah, had outstanding was $6,180,000. Now our discount on bonds payable here cash will be at the rate 103%. So here 6,180,000 multiplied by 103%. Now discount on bonds payable is of $185,400. Now here we can see that there is a loss on redemption of bonds. Which is equal to $370,800. So here is our journal entry to record the refunding of bonds. So here is our solution. In case any doubt, you can ask me through comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you.